How often do we refer to wrestling as a soap opera for men, Mike Tanay? It happens all the time, but what goes on, what goes on behind the scenes can really be a soap opera. And today on the WCW Hotline, Mean Gene Okerlund has some inside skinny on some romantic interludes happening backstage in WCW.
Oh, really? Today on the WCW Hotline, that's what Mean Gene has?
That's what he's got. I wonder if he's involved with that blonde we saw on Sunday.
Rumors have it. You know, this Monday, I have a complete week in review detailing all the results, all the news, but I know you want to know the dirt that's on Gene's hotline today. There's only one way.
What
call 1-900-909-9900.
All the dish you want, 1-900-909-9900.
World Championship Wrestling fans, listen up, because this upcoming week we have three important on-sale announcements. Next Thursday, WCW tickets go on sale for a major arena event in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, on February the 26th at the Winnipeg Arena. Plus, you can meet the Canadian Crippler, Chris Benoit, next Thursday at the arena box office at 9:30 a.m. Now, next Friday, tickets go on sale in Reno, Nevada. World Championship Wrestling is bringing Thunder to the Lawler Event Center on February the 22nd.
Wait a minute. The what?
The Lawler Event Center. It's Reno, Nevada. L-A-W-L-O-R.
Oh, okay. Go on.
Well, I'm glad I have your approval.
Please.
1 week from today, next Saturday, January the 15th, tickets go on sale for Thunder in Fargo, North Dakota at the Fargo Dome. The date of the live event will be February the 29th, and you can meet Screamin' Norman Smiley, our reigning WCW Hardcore Champion, at the box office in Fargo next Saturday from 10 a.m. to noon.
Bring your earplugs to Fargo. Screamin' Wiggler himself, Norman Smiley, at the on sale. We talked earlier about Team Power Plant. Kid Romeo is in the ring. What an unbelievable athlete this guy is. You knew he would just pick a sport and excel at it, and he looked really tough in the ring, but he is taking on another member of Team Power Plant in Big Mike Commander.
And Scott, if you think back to the last few months of 1999, this program on so many occasions highlighted the elite from the WCW Power Plant, those youngsters now that are gaining so much up-close experience every Monday at Nitro, sitting ringside. But right here on the Superstation TBS on Saturday night, they have a chance to shine inside the squared circle. And Kid Romeo and Mike Sanders are going to try to prove to one another and the world that they belong in WCW.
These two men, both part of Team Power Plant, there is some mutual respect here. They will throw it out the window and try to win the contest, but my guess would be that after the show, they may get together, watch the tape, figure out exactly what went right, what went wrong in this matchup. Something that will not happen 1 week from tomorrow night when Diamond Dallas Page steps into the ring with Buff Daddy himself, Buff Bagwell.
Wow, what a wild one that is, as Sanders goes for a quick cover and gets a two count. No rules, no referee. Plain and simple, last man standing wins, as we see the roll through, and Romeo gets a two count on Sanders, both men with near falls in the opening minute. When you talk about Diamond Dallas Page and Buff Bagwell, this is much more than a wrestling rivalry or grudge. This is personal, and right in between DDP and Buff Bagwell is Kimberly Page.
Oh, please. Are you kidding me? That's just where Buff Bagwell wants her. If you'll let that out later on. Did you hear the shoot interview from Diamond Dallas Page Thursday on Sunday?
Can I hear it? I was sitting right next to you. Am I invisible or something?
Well, Kid Romeo from the top. He may have landed on that left knee, but I mean, he wiped out Mike Sanders. I don't think we can even play any of Diamond Dallas Page's interview from Thursday. That whole thing was a complete bleep. They brawled up into the stands. DDP told it like it was, and Buff Bagwell heard enough.
Oh, he did. DDP told it like it was. Buff Bagwell's going to be happy to hear you say that.
Well, I don't know that it's all accurate, but you know.
He just said he told it like it was.
He told what he believed to be true. What are you going to do? Get me in touch with Buff?
Well, sure.
Well, go do it. Kid Romeo putting the chop to Mike Sanders. Maybe celebrating a bit too early. Sanders.
Whoa!
Chopping the light
the things we've noticed from young Mike Sanders, that level of intensity. Oh, and a great move by Sanders. Great counter. When Kid Romeo went for the flying head scissors, Sanders reversed it out of the corner and slammed him back first to the canvas.
We heard the rumors for many, many weeks about what went down in Denver. Hang on a second. Sanders! Oh!
Standing moonsault from the ring apron by Mike Sanders onto Kid Romeo.
They are really taking chances here. The rumors involving Cage and Bagwell from Denver. The brawl at catering. And they weren't fighting over the planks, Dave, if you know what I'm saying to you. They were brawling over the allegation. Oh, hang on. Lateral press. Sanders on top. Romeo rolled a shoulder at two. The allegations that Bagwell has been putting the old moves on the beautiful Kimberly Page. Page does not take that lightly.
DDP talked about his timeout in Los Angeles, filming the WCW Warner Brothers movie, Ready to Rumble. And the fact that, well, when DDP was away from home, Buff Bagwell tried to put the moves on Kimberly.
Did not like the allegations, Diamond Dallas Page and Buff Bagwell. There were plenty more backstage brawls that never made the internet, never made the newsletters, never made the hotlines. They were separated many, many times backstage at WCW live events and television tapings. But I tell you what, there will be no separating them. Come rolled out in 8 days. When they hook up, no rules, no ref, there will be a winner. There may not be but one survivor.
Well, one would expect that would be the case. DDP, Buff Bagwell, 1 week from tomorrow, it's sold out. They will settle the score.
Sanders and Romeo putting on a textbook clinic here. Sanders misses with a wild lariat. That was enough. No, interfering. Good night. Kicked his hair off.
Just about took the head of Mike Sanders right off of his shoulders with the Enziguri kick.
Oh,
listen to the
running
impact of that clothesline.
Reversal. Romeo into the rope. Sanders leapfrog. Go. Romeo cut him off. Oh, ho.
Short power bomb gets two and
two.
Sanders able to escape at two. Look how quickly Kid Romeo back to his feet and quickly up to the top rope.
Oh, like a cat. Up top. Wow! With authority, what snap on that top rope Hurricane Rana. Oh! That may do it. Lateral press with the near leg and it's over.
This will do it. The Romeo recliner for Kid Romeo as he scores what is indeed a very impressive victory here on WCW Saturday night. Kid Romeo ruled the power plant.
At sold out. This time, it is very personal, and it's all about the woman. Diamond Dallas Page defending the honor of his beautiful wife, Kimberly, against Buff Bagwell. For once and for all, Page and Buff Daddy, that sold out.